Hi, everyone. Last week, I had the incredible opportunity to speak at the Women in Tech Summit here in Philadelphia. It was such an amazing experience, and I wanted to share it with you. The Women in Tech Summit is a national series of events that inspire, educate, and connects women in technology. It was such an honor to represent my team and share my knowledge with other women. I had the opportunity to speak on the topic of bridging the gap between intersectionality and technology. I talked about the importance of considering intersectionality when developing technology and how it can lead to a more inclusive and accessible technology for everyone. I also had the chance to attend sessions led by some incredible speakers like Grace Francisco and Jillian Ivey. They talked about some incredible topics and led me with some powerful messages. Check out my blog post to read all about my experience at the Women in Tech Summit and my insight on bridging intersectionality and technology. I've also added a video highlight for you to see all that went down at the event. The link to the blog post will be in the description below.
A new quarterly blog series has been started to highlight the newly released features of SAP Build Apps. In her first blog, Eshme announced the following four features. You can now easily chart your data with four new chart components: line, bar, pie, and area charts. You just bind your data like any other component to the chart data property, and voila, you have a chart. All these components are available in the marketplace. Another significant improvement is the SAP Build Apps Booster, making it much easier to set up SAP Build Apps with your free tier or paid service plan in SAP BTP. Most significantly, the booster handles setting up a custom identity provider, which is required for using SAP Build Apps. A more advanced feature is the new iframe component, which lets you embed custom code into your app. For example, Kirill's recent blog explains how you can embed React components within your project. And finally, the name of the default page when you create a new project has been changed from empty page to home page. Many users had reported that the previous name was confusing, and therefore it was changed. Eshme's blog comes just after recent blogs about new features in SAP Build Process Automation and SAP Build Workzone. I'll put links to all the blogs, including Clearall's blog, in the description. And finally, there are still a few days left, including the weekend, to participate in the fun of the SAP Build Challenge. It's a great way to learn SAP Build, and hundreds have already entered. And remember, you only need to complete 2 of the 5 challenges in order to be eligible for the SAP Build Challenge badge. So please participate and enjoy.
Just in case you don't know, SAP BTP Innobytes is a monthly series of fresh, snackable SAP BTP insights that you can quickly consume and share. The April 2023 edition is out and contains highlights on performance classes and near zero downtime operations on SAP HANA Cloud, new advanced features of the scheduler in the cloud integration capability of SAP Integration Suite, and also the integration of SAP BTP ABAP environment with SAP Cloud Transport Management. Check out the video that has all the details. The link is in the description. Also, did you know that it's SAP BTP Innobytes' birthday? Help celebrate by filling in a really short survey to share your thoughts and views about the series. The link to the survey is also in the description.
This week's developer news is packed with great announcements for mobile. First up, a new openSAP course is coming up on May 31st about understanding and implementing the SAP mobile experience. The course is starting from a big picture perspective. We'll drill down into concrete scenarios and show you how mobile experiences can be used to enhance your business. The course is set for 3 weeks, with the final exam being on June 21st. So head over to open.sap.com to read more. Next, we have a new release for the mobile development kit available to all mobile services customers. the new version has quite some highlights like new UI components, enhancements for existing controls like the section header, and the support for validating a digitally signed QR code during the onboarding process on both Android and iOS clients. Reach Tendra Consult's blog post to learn more. And lastly, we have SAP Mobile Day 2023 coming up. The event is happening on June 20th in Berlin, Germany. For those of you who don't know what SAP Mobile Day is, it is an event where customers, partners, and SAP experts which find their home within mobile technologies come together to explore trends and exchange best practices in mobile development and design. Learn, experience, and explore SAP's partners and various other developers' mobile offerings and practices. For more information, visit Florian Herrich's blog post on blogs.sap.com or the SAP Mobile Days website. And as always, all links are provided in the description of this video.